Hello, y'all on YouTube. This is Rob with Rob's Nerdy Knives. I have a very special unboxing, something that came in from White and Mountain Knives. Been looking forward to this. So let's get into this real quick. I'm going to open it because the label's down here below. So keep that kind of confidential real quick. Today I'm opening up with my Protech Mordax Bigfoot knife that I finally found. Bigfoot has been found. So there we go. All right, let me go ahead and open this. Oh, hold on. Let's bring that back. So let me go ahead and bring this up open. Here we go. Do we have anything in here? No, we don't. All right. Oh, a couple of peanuts. We'll put that over there. All right. So this is an artisan cutlery. I have gotten CJRB before, but not artisan cutlery. It is made in China. This is the 1825GGY. Very nice box. Really cool. Look at that little gold emblem on there. All right. So let's go ahead and pop this open. Nice inner lining. Look at that. Little silica. High quality precision. Let's see what we have in here. Okay, so we've got some silicate packet. We've got a nice cloth, definitely worth putting over there. Another silicate packet, and in here we have a pretty cool knife. Let's see what this is. This is the Satyr. It's a special knife that was designed, and I'm super excited to bring this to you. All right. This is called a Satyr. I believe it's S-A-T-Y-R. Really cool design. I forget who the designer is, but look at the beautiful milling on this thing. Titanium milling. I believe these are all T8s. Are they T8s? Oh my goodness. Is that really T8s? All right, so here we go. Sorry, I have to stop for a second. I'm super excited if it is. Oh. Oh, yeah. T8s. Really, really cool. Sorry, that was just totally random, but couple of screws here, one here, one here, one here. You do have probably, I'm going to guess that's probably T6 for the steel bar insert over travel stop. Hidden deep pocket carry clip, but a titanium, nice and thin, so it does have flexibility, but it's a hidden screw. So it's inside, probably going all the way through here, which is really cool. Nicely chamfered all the way around. Is it sharp? It's not terribly sharp anywhere. I mean, it's not as smooth as it could be, but it's nice. Nice, got some jimping on top. All right, let's see, how's the centering? It's nice and centered, yeah. We'll have to flick that open here in just a second. All right, so let's see how this goes. Oh, look at that. Oh, look at that beautiful satin polish kind of finish there. Look at that. So this is artisan cutler. Let's see here, what do we have? I don't know who's the designer. There's a little dog on there, so maybe that's the designer. What do we got here? We got about, looks like a good 50% lockup. No blade play. Let's see, how's the action on this thing? Nice. Can flip forward. All right, so when I drop it here, all right, so this choil catches on the finger. That's nice. Let's see, how does it do left-handed? It does work left-handed. It's a little tight right now, just opening it up. Let's see, let's break that in. Probably need a little bit of oil, or we'll do a little, let's see here, can I get in there? All right, it's a little tight right now. And that's probably because it's just breaking in. Nice. I do like that. So this is a really cool design. Full titanium, no cutouts. Got a little bit of weight to it. It's not super light, but it's not super heavy, which is nice because it's very thin. You can see that, very thin. You see artisan cutlery very nicely embossed there. It's not standing out, very showy. The only thing I wish, like this is perfect on the logo. That's not too bad. I mean, it could be worse, right? S90V blade steel, which is really nice. So we'll see how that sharpens up and how well that works. So let's see here. Can we figure it out? All right, I'll eventually figure this out, right? So we'll get this. We'll get there. Yeah, it's a little, I got to figure this out here. I don't know if it's because it's just tight right now. I'm assuming because it's a little tight. Left-handed over here works really nicely. That works great. S90V blade steel is really nice. It is very, very nice. I love the finish on the blade. Nice and rounded, no sharp edges up here. Got a good sharp edge. It looks almost like a full flat grind, but it's not. It's got a little flat part here. No swedge on here. So, but definitely, looks like it could be certainly slicey. Comes down to a pretty relatively thinness. It's not super, super thick or aggressive, right? Action's getting in there. It's getting better. It's getting better. And we'll see if maybe we put some skiff washers on this, if that make it look better. So I'm looking forward to that. So I'm trying to figure out where is the sweet spot on this thing here. All right, so I've yet to figure that out. We'll work on that a little bit. Now's not the time. Let's talk a little bit about the knife. All right, it is nicely chamfered all the way around. This, I would say, it could be a little softer on the edges. It's not terrible. Yeah, it's not hard, but it's not comfortable, right? It's not, you know, a little chamfering right here. Just a little chamfering. A little, you know, it could be micro chamfering all the way around would be nice, you know? Just to round that off. That, I think, would go a long way, especially on the edges here. It's not terrible, don't get me wrong. A little sharp on the edge up here as well. Not terrible, but I will tell you, man, let me clean off that edge here. Just look at that milling on here. So let's zoom in a little bit here. Look at that milling on that handle. Really, really nice. And it does look like it is not a captive pivot, so you're going to need two screws for that. But even the milling is on the deep pocket carry clip, which is really cool. Yeah, it's nice and soft right there. That's cool. And then there's the blade, S90V, which is nice. Look at it on this side. Really cool. So let's drop it out a little bit. So it does flip really nicely. I think when it breaks in a little bit more, it's going to be nice. It's going to be really nice. Everybody who's reviewed this seems to really, really like this knife. I forget who the guy who designed it, but it seems to be, get in there, really popular. All right, make sure, yeah, edges, everything's nice there. Nothing sharp. That's cool. It's got some jimping, very functional jimping. It does work. You can sort of choke up like that if you wanted to. I have large hands. You can see that. So extra large, maybe double extra large, especially if you choke up a little bit, for sure. That'll definitely work. It is a, you know, about a 3 1/4 inch blade, so nice big belly to it. It is almost a straight back. I don't know if you call it a drop point. It comes here and goes down here. So technically, I guess that's a drop point, but it almost seems like a straight back, right? It almost seems like a straight back. But technically, I guess that's a drop point. Or you can call it a modified straight back drop point, whatever you want to call it. That's what it's going to be. So, yeah. So definitely can see that. All right, so let's zoom out again. So I like this. I think it's a pretty cool little knife. Not bad. Yep, definitely dead center. Did keep its retention. Let's see here. Can we slow roll it? Yeah, we absolutely can slow roll it for sure. All right. I think skiffs is going to be really nice for this one. We'll definitely do a video on skiffs, but definitely worth checking out. I like that a lot. Really cool. Look at that. All right. So this is the Satya. By Artisan Cutlery. It's not CJRB, but it's actually Artisan Cutlery. It's my first Artisan Cutlery. I have had a bunch of CJRBs, but I haven't had any Artisan Cutlery. I seem to like the design language of CJRB more than I do Artisan Cutlery, but I still like it. Still like it a lot. Very, very cool little knife. I think it's definitely worth checking out. It's under $200, $199. That's what makes this really amazing. S90V blade steel, beautiful milled titanium. This polished kind of satin finish, that's just really gorgeous. Almost semi-reflective, I think that's really cool, okay? So action's pretty nice. I love thumb hole, whatever you want to call it. Finger hole, whatever, you know, you see in reverse deploy, really, really nice. Yeah, that's definitely gonna be breaking in a little better. I want to be able to figure this out over here. I just don't want to do it here, wasting your guys' time. Oh, I finally got one. There we go. All right. Definitely pretty sharp. Let's see, how's that edge? Did I check that out? Looks pretty. Yeah, it's a little longer on this side than this side. I would probably have to reprofile. That's not perfect. It's not bad. It's not perfect. So definitely really cool. Cool little knife. I like a lot of the aesthetics on here. Very nice. Very, very nice. Does it get all the way through here? No? Okay, good. You're definitely big belly blade. You definitely need all that. It's almost got pretty good advantage of the handle to blade ratio. There's no lanyard hole. I don't miss that at all, and I'm fine with that. So that's really cool. Really neat. All right, so this is definitely the Artisan Cutlery Satya, I believe it's called. And I'll make sure, if I'm wrong, I'm going to put it in the title and a description, and then I'll put it up here. If I know the designer, I'll make sure I'll try to put in there that as well, but maybe we'll talk about that in the review. But really cool little knife. Do like that a lot. Very, very cool. All right, so this is the Artisan Cutlery Sautier. Hey, what else? Did I forget anything? Just as unboxing, first impressions. That's really what we're doing here. Anything else jump out at me? No, I think that's about it. But really, really cool little knife. All right. Hey, if you found this content fun, interesting, worthwhile, or informative, would you please consider hitting the like button down below? And if you've already hit that like button, maybe consider hitting the subscribe button. Subscribing and liking the videos really helps out the channel. It allows me to grow, allows me to produce more content, do more things, ultimately more things for you guys. So thank you. If you've done all that, maybe hit the notification button down below so you can be notified of future content. And to all my channel members, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you for being a channel member, supporting the channel. You guys really make this possible. So thank you. And if you haven't already, maybe you want to become a channel member, it'd be an awesome time to do so. I'd love to have you. I have three different tiers, very affordable to, you know, $10 if you're wanting to really go crazy and support the channel. I would love that. So thank you. Thank you to all you guys. And if you haven't already, maybe check me out over on Instagram at @Rob's_nerdy_knives. Again, that's on Instagram at @Rob's_nerdy_knives. Thanks so much for watching today. Have a great day and a great week. Bye.